गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबॉडी, माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर विशेष कौशिक। आई एम फ्रॉम पंडित भगवत दयाल शर्मा पोस्ट ग्रेजुएट इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ मेडिकल साइंसेज रोहतक। आई एम प्रेजेंटिंग अ केस ऑफ न्यूरोएंडोक्राइन ट्यूमर ऑफ द टॉन्सिलर फोसा। द ऑब्जेक्टिव इज टू प्रेजेंट अ रेयर केस ऑफ टॉन्सिलर न्यूरोएंडोक्राइन ट्यूमर एंड एस्टैब्लिश इट्स इमेजिंग फीचर्स एंड एक्सटेंशंस। इंट्रोडक्शन। टॉन्सिल इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट कॉमन साइट्स फ्रॉम वेयर प्राइमरी ओरोफेरिंजियल ट्यूमर अराइज। The most common tumor in this area is squamous cell carcinoma, while minor salivary gland tumors, lymphomas, melanoma and sarcomas are also included. The incidence of neuroendocrine tumor of head and neck is low and mainly arises in the larynx followed by salivary glands, nose and paranasal sinuses. According to the latest WHO classification of head and neck tumors, typical and atypical carcinoid are well differentiated neuroendocrine cancers. And small cell neuroendocrine cancer is classified as poorly differentiated tumor. Large cell neuroendocrine cancer is also a poorly differentiated tumor which has been well established in the pulmonary neuroendocrine tumors. But whether it should be defined as a distinct entity in neuroendocrine tumors of head and neck is still under debate. Aim: to study the role of imaging in a neuroendocrine tumor of tonsil, which is an extreme rarity. Through imaging, the extent of the tumor and its relation with the adjacent structures can be described, which can further help to narrow down differentials and decide method of treatment. Case history. A 48-year-old male chronic smoker was referred to the radiology department for CCT neck with history of neck swelling on left side and throat pain since 3 months. History of odynophagia was present. Physical examination revealed left-sided ulceroproliferative growth with fullness in anterior tonsillar pillar. Right palatine tonsil was normal. Multiple palpable lymph nodes were present on left side. CCT, CMRI and USG examination of the patient was performed. Biopsy of the tonsillar mass was taken and sent for histology. Imaging findings. CCT neck was performed on a 16-slice machine. It showed an ill-defined heterogeneously enhancing soft tissue lesion in the left tonsillar fossa with few hypertense foci which were suggestive of tonsillolith. Anteriorly, the lesion was involving base of tongue left side. And inferiorly, the lesion was involving the left lateral pharyngeal wall. Left valacula was partially obliterated. Multiple heterogeneously enhancing lymph nodal masses were seen at level 2, 3, 4 and 5 on the left side. Major neck vessels, retropharyngeal space, bilateral parotid and some mandibular glands were unremarkable. So these are the images. In this axial sections and coronal section, we can see a heterogeneously enhancing mass lesion in the left tonsillar fossa. In this coronal section, we can see multiple lymph nodes along the left jugulodigastric chain. CMRI was also performed on 3 Tesla system. Contrast enhanced images were acquired in T1 weighted, T2 weighted and diffusion weighted sequences in axial, sagittal and coronal planes. A well-defined lesion was seen in left tonsillar fossa, which was hypo-intense on T1 weighted and hyper-intense on T2 weighted imaging. On post-contrast scan, slight peripheral enhancement was noted. The lesion was also involving the uvula and extending into the left valacula. It appeared to be involving the left posterior aspect of base of the tongue. Multiple enlarged lymph nodes showing signal intensity similar to the lesion were seen in the left cervical and supraclavicular area. So, in this T2 axial sequence, we can see a hyper-intense lesion involving the left tonsil and also involving the posterior lateral aspect of the tongue. There are lymph nodes which are showing the same signal intensity as of the lesion. On DWI, there was evidence of restriction. In this coronal imaging, the lesion is T2 hyper-intense. So these are the contrast enhanced sections. In this coronal image, the lesion is showing peripheral enhancement. These are the lymph nodes. These are also showing peripheral enhancement. In this sagittal section, the lesion seems to be involving the base of the tongue. Ultrasound neck showed multiple necrotic lymph nodes on left side of the neck. USG abdomen showed multiple round target lesion suggestive of liver metastasis. All the imaging features were in favor of neoplastic soft tissue mass of left tonsillar fossa with metastatic cervical lymphadenopathy and liver metastasis. Finally, the biopsy was done and histopathology revealed neuroendocrine carcinoma of the left tonsillar fossa. On immunohistochemistry, tumor cells were CK positive, which showed dot-like positivity, chromogranin neg positive, P63 negative. So these are the ultrasound images. In this, the liver shows multiple Target shape lesions of variable sizes scattered throughout the liver, which were suggestive of liver mets, and this image showed necrotic lymph nodal mass on the left side of the neck. Discussion. Neuroendocrine carcinoma is an epithelial malignancy with neuroendocrine differentiation which has been reported in many organs throughout the body. NEC of the oropharynx is rare. Immunohistochemistry analysis usually demonstrate the positive staining for general neuroendocrine markers including senotophysin, CD56 and chromogranin. Current evidence suggests that oropharyngeal neuroendocrine cancers is more aggressive than the more commonly encountered squamous cell carcinoma with a poorer prognosis. It has a propensity to develop early regional lymphatic and systemic metastasis, therefore should be considered a systemic disease from the outset. The treatment of the extrapulmonary neuroendocrine tumor depends on whether the tumor is resectable, loco-regionally advanced but unresectable or metastatic. Patients with small cell tumors are more likely to receive chemoradiation as the primary treatment modality, while those with other neuroendocrine tumor types are more likely to undergo surgical resection. To conclude, in this particular case, patient came with history of neck swelling left side. Imaging features were suggestive of malignant mass left tonsillar fossa with cervical nodal and liver metastasis. On histopathology, the mass turned out to be neuroendocrine carcinoma of the tonsil, which is a rare entity. Imaging helped us to see the extension of the tumor, its relation with the adjacent structures and loco-regional and distant metastasis, which is important for planning the treatment. Here are the references. Thank you very much.